A big part of social psychology centers around how we influence and relate to those around us. We don't live in a vacuum. Our decisions, behaviors, attitudes, beliefs, thoughts are all subject to social influence. And researchers who are interested in studying social influence are interested in examining why we are influenced, how we are influenced, who influences us, and so much more. In this social influence research close-up, we start with a question. Do social influences affect health decisions and behaviors? Specifically, we'll discuss the ways in which people influence our decisions to seek or avoid health information. Let's start with an example. Let's say you're at a party. You've been eating lots and lots of good food, and you go to the bathroom and notice there's a scale. Do you step on the scale and weigh yourself? Or would you rather avoid that information? Although weighing ourselves does provide some potentially useful information about our health, we may choose to engage in information avoidance. And information avoidance is when we decide to delay or prevent acquiring available but potentially unwanted information. In this case, information about our weight. Now, imagine in that scenario that the scale is in a public place, and that if you choose to weigh yourself, other people around you may notice that you're weighing yourself and may see your weight. Does that change your decision as to whether or not you want to avoid the information? Now, this example illustrates a key point. That is that our decisions to seek or avoid health information are not just personal. They can be interpersonal. Other people can and do influence our decisions to seek or avoid information. Importantly, certain people may be more powerful in influencing our decisions than others. People who have the capacity or the potential to harm us with information, whether they're harming us financially, interpersonally, or otherwise, tend to be more powerful in influencing our health decisions. How do we know this? Well, in a series of studies I conducted, participants were given the opportunity to learn some important information about their general health, their risk for heart disease, diabetes, and several forms of cancer. So really valuable information. However, some participants learned that if they chose to seek this health risk feedback, it would be automatically sent to an insurer database or to an employer database. And these represent two groups of people that are high in power. They are powerful groups of people that we may not want to potentially share all of our information with. Other participants learned that if they chose to get their health risk feedback, it would be sent automatically to a health researcher database or to no one, just themselves. And these represent two groups of people that are low power. They have little reason or capacity to harm us with the information they may receive. So, what do we find? Do participants actually differ in their decisions to seek or avoid information depending on who has access to the information? It turns out yes. So, participants who thought their information would be sent to insurers or employers were far more likely to avoid their health risk feedback than participants who thought their information would be sent to health researchers or to no one. So, what's the take-home point? As this research illustrates, our health decisions are influenced by other people. But not all people influence us equally. How much power people have, how much we trust them, and many other characteristics can affect just how influential these people are. So, next time you're making a health decision, think about the factors that are influencing your decision. Chances are, some of them are probably social.